Good evening and welcome to the very first ever presidential media chat of President Muhammadu Buhari. It is a pleasure for me personally to have the opportunity of having this conversation along with a number of journalists who are here today with our president, President Muhammadu Buhari. There are tons of issues that Nigerians have asked, and some they're waiting to ask, and they're expecting answers to all of these questions. So we're expecting that Mr. President has all the answers to all the questions that we will be asking today. Well, I will not waste too much time in introducing or going too far with this introduction. So I will start by first acknowledging the fact that we have seated here this evening the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Mr. President, President Muhammadu Buhari. Good evening and welcome to your media chat.
Thank you very much.
So I will then use the opportunity to introduce my colleagues who are fellow journalists who are here. I will start with the lady on the panel, the only one today, Dr. Ngozi Ayegbunam, who is a writer, a journalist, and former member of the editorial board of Champion Newspapers and also Daily Times. Good evening and welcome.
Thank you.
And also sitting next to him is Manir Dang Ali, who is who was a journalist with the BBC and now the editor-in-chief of the Daily Trust, Manir. Great to have you on the panel. And just sitting on my right-hand side is Mbaga Isine, who is a journalist that has worked with NTA, then the Punch newspaper, and now he is with the online newspaper, Premium Times, as the regional editor. Mbaga, great to have you.
Thank you very much.
So, let us start, Mr. President. I will say that Nigerians fell in love with you at the beginning of the year when the campaign was really very intense. And one of the things that they said they fell in love with was the fact that you stand as a man of integrity and you stand against corruption that, in your own words, you said, will kill Nigeria if we do not kill corruption. Now the nation has signed on the dotted line, we're married to you, and you're married to us. According to you, you belong to all of us, and you belong to nobody. So having said that, we're looking at the period of the honeymoon. The honeymoon has been on for a while now, 7 months to be precise. I wonder how long that would last. But talking about corruption, to be precise, Mr. President, how do you think we are doing with the fight against corruption now?
I think we are doing quite well, considering the circumstances. Firstly, I think this will be best illustrated by my personal experience. 30 years ago, when I was in uniform, and I found myself here as the head of state of Nigeria, we collected those that are perceived to be corrupt and put them in protective custody. And we told them that they are guilty until they can prove themselves innocent. Now I am here in a different form, in a multi-party democratic system, and the nations that we are looking forward for their cooperation under the circumstances we find ourselves, security-wise, economic-wise, even morally, the only acceptable system to them is those suspected of being corrupt are innocent until they are proved guilty. Having said that, we have been lucky to find some documents where public funds were diverted into personal pockets. We have some documents where Nigerian crude oil was lifted illegally and the proceeds were put into some personal accounts instead of the federal government accounts. And of course, we have started going to court as we get evidence, routine evidence. We are taking those people to court. And for whatever is in the court, we cannot comment until we see what they do with the documents we have presented and how the Nigerian Ministry of Justice under the Attorney General and the Minister of Justice taking our constitution into account, see how we can get out of it. But there are terrible cases of corruption, and we can only appeal to Nigerians to be patient.
Okay, Mr. President, you know that some members of your government have said that some money has been collected from those who were found to be corrupt and money have been taken back. How much and why are we not finding names of those who were deemed corrupt, who we have been able to get the money back from them?
I've already told you our main constraint, that eventually the persons have to find themselves in court. And under whatever circumstances, we cannot prejudge what the court will do. But the document we are going to submit and how the government will react to it through the Ministry of Justice is what we have to develop the patience to do. Because once we go to court, then we should keep our mouths shut. Nothing wrong, I believe, in raising issues, but then we cannot determine issues while they are still in court.
Does that mean that no money has been recovered from the stolen funds?
Money has been recovered. But the fact that we are, whatever we recover, we have to end up in court. Because I feel personally, as a president, Nigerian, entitled to know the truth. And the truth will be what the court have discovered by the submission made to them in terms of documentation, and the documentation including the bank statements, where money is recovered, where it was lodged, when it was lodged, how much and which source, whether it is petrol, money from NNPC, or money from custom and excise, FAS, or money directly, you know, from central bank. When we do that, I think Nigerians then may feel a bit better.